We're going to talk for a few minutes about Baltimore City's high-pressure system, which was put in service in April of 1912. Now, this was one of the greatest improvements installed in the city or made to the city after the Great Fire of 1904. So when this was put in service in 1912, they could supply the what we call the financial district, which was basically the burnt district of the Great Fire, plus some extra footage, with 250 pounds per square inch of water. This was mostly potable water. They did have the capability of drafting water directly from the hydrant. They also had the capability of having a fireboat come up and supply water through manifolds at the bottom of Cheapside in case the pumps should break at the pumping station. So they had three levels of redundancy for the three big Corliss engines that supplied the pressure to these mains. And it was in service until the late 1970s. And the pumps, the modern pumps, are still in place. The steam engines were replaced in, I believe, in 1965. So, that being said, this plaque is the dedicatory plaque of the pumping station itself, which was on South Street. It's now been demolished and the bank sits there. But this pumping station had to be close enough to the Inner Harbor to get water from the Inner Harbor if they needed that. And there's some interesting stories about that issue with the harbor water. But it also was fed by two 20-inch mains, one from the east and one from the west, which were part of the grid for Baltimore City's drinking water. So this green cylinder represents one of three of the surge chambers of the pumping station. One of them had the plaque. Each one of these surge chambers was next to a Corliss engine, and each of these had a water motor driven main that would allow the water to come into that respective pump. So under normal circumstances, there was only domestic hydrant pressure on these mains, but as soon as an alarm of fire was sounded in the high pressure district through the telegraph system, the engineer on duty at the pumping station would start the first Corliss engine and bring their line up to 250 pounds, which I'm sure he could have done by the time the first engine responded to the fire. And if they started to use the high pressure system, then as the water pressure diminished, he would speed the engine up to a point where the engine was where it should be, its norm. Then he would start a second engine and a third engine until the pumping station was pumping at capacity, which was 21,000 gallons of water per minute at 250 pounds per square inch. The boilers that fed these engines were hand-fired and coal-burning, and I had a friend that used to have an office downtown, and he said he could always tell when there was a fire in the high-pressure district because the smoke would start belching out of the stacks. They had four steel stacks in a square. It was the only pump. It was the only building in the city that had these four stacks in, like, a square. And they would all, well, they were in banks of two, so depending on how many boilers they were firing, they would start to belch the black smoke because they were overcharging the fireboxes to get to deal with the consumption. The pumping station also supplied district steam to all of the city buildings and fire department headquarters. So City Hall, all the municipal buildings, the fire department headquarters, Peel, all of these buildings were supplied by district steam. So this was another new concept for Baltimore in 1912. And then they sold steam to BGE, Baltimore Gas and Electric Company, who then distributed the steam to new customers in the downtown area. So they, each of these customers were no longer required to keep a boiler on their premises. They could just rent steam, as it were, buy steam from the high-pressure grid. This is something that's done in a lot of cities now. There's also stories about when they had a big fire, they would need to cut off these supply lines to the district steam, and then people would get cold, so they had a problem there once in a while. We have no idea how often that might have happened, but it certainly happened enough that the old folks that lived and worked downtown had some chilly offices for a while because some huge fire was going in the high pressure district.
Thank you, Steve.